Scholastic Audio presents Upside Down Magic by Sarah Mlynowski, Emily Jenkins, and Lauren Miracle. Read by Rebecca Soler. For David, of course. Chapter 1. Nory Horace was trying to turn herself into a kitten. The kitten had to be a black kitten, and it had to be completely kitten-shaped. It was the middle of summer. Nory was hiding in her family's garage. Kitten, 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 she thought. She was hiding in case something went wrong. She didn't want anyone to see. Still, if something went really wrong, her brother and sister would be close enough to hear her yell for help. Or meow for help. Or roar. Nory decided not to think about that. Hopefully, she wouldn't need help. Kitten, kitten, kitten. She had to master kitten, because tomorrow was the big test. Tomorrow, after so many years of waiting, she would finally take the entrance exam for Sage Academy. The school was very hard to get into. You wouldn't be accepted with anything less than amazing talents. Nori's friends weren't even bothering to try. They were all taking tests for easier schools. If Nory passed the big test, she would start fifth grade at Sage Academy in the fall. If she failed the test, no, she couldn't fail. She wasn't taking tests for any other schools. Not only because Sage Academy was a very important, very fancy magic school, but also because her brother Hawthorne went there. And her sister Dahlia did too. Plus, Nori's father was kind of the headmaster. Okay, not kind of, he was definitely the headmaster. Thinking about the big test made Nory queasy. Her magic was strong, there was no doubt about that. But sometimes, her magic went wonky. And Sage Academy did not want wonky. A black kitten was likely to be on the big test tomorrow. It was a beginner animal. Nory had turned herself into a black kitten loads of times, actually. The problem was what happened after. But Nory would not think about that. Instead, she took a deep breath and lifted her chin. Kitten, kitten, kitten! The world went blurry, and Nori's heart beat faster. Her body stretched and shrank. There were popping sounds. Yay, kitten! But wait, her mouth felt wrong. Nory clacked her teeth together. Clack, clack, clack. Whoa. These weren't normal teeth. These were long. These were sharp. These were powerful. Long, sharp, and powerful enough to chomp through wood. Nory thought, feeling odd. Why would a kitten want to chomp wood? Nory looked over her shoulder. She saw a perfect black kitten tail swishing in the air. Connected to the tail was a set of black kitten legs with padded feet and sharp claws. She looked down, expecting to see a matching set of front legs where her arms used to be. But her front legs weren't kitten legs. The fur was brown and slick. Also, she seemed to have a fat, round tummy. And what was this nose? She couldn't see it well, but it had nothing kittenish about it. It was more of a snout. A beaver nose. Zamboozle, I'm half kitten and half beaver, Nory realized. Her magic had definitely gone wonky. Not again, she thought. What am I doing wrong? I'll fail the big test if I do this tomorrow. I should change back right away and try again for perfect kitten. Yes, that's exactly what I should do. But the beaver kitten part of Nory wouldn't listen. Beaver kitten Nory didn't care about the big test. Beaver kitten Nory just wanted to chew stuff with her awesome beaver teeth. She searched the garage. Wood. Where was the wood around here? Must chew, Beaver kitten Nory thought. Must make beaver dam. No, no, said the dim voice of girl Nory. Beaver kitten Nory waddled out of the garage and into the house. Then she went upstairs and into her father's office. Tree stumps would do, or branches, anything really made of wood. Nory spotted her father's bookshelf. It was very beautiful, having been lovingly built over 200 years ago by craftsmen in Europe. It was a very important, very expensive piece of furniture. It looked delicious. Ooh, Beaver Kitten Nory thought. Look at that, a wooden tall thing, chewy rectangle things. She nudged one of the books onto the floor and nibbled it. Hard on the outside like bark, tender on the inside like leaves. Mmm, chew, 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 Beaver Kitten Nory gnawed through four of her father's books. Then she bit through the legs of her father's solid oak desk. Next, she chewed off a section of her father's favorite armchair. She dragged fluff and wood into the guest bathroom and built a small beaver lodge under the sink. Then she chased her kitten tail for a couple minutes and used a pile of ripped-up pages for a litter box. It was awesome. She was awesome. She, Beaver Kitten Nory, felt better than she had in weeks. At least until her brother Hawthorne found her. Chapter 2. Hawthorne was 16. He took care of most of the house stuff because their father, Dr. Horace, was too busy and important to be bothered with making dinner and braiding hair. And because their mother wasn't around. She had died a long time ago. Hawthorne liked sports and cooking and bossing people around. He also liked setting things on fire, since he was a flare. A really good flare, too. His powers never went wonky. Nory! Hawthorne cried now, staring at the beaver lodge. What are you doing? Beaver kitten Nory tried to rub her face on Hawthorne's pant leg. I don't even know what you are right now, he went on. But you better change back and help me clean up. Seriously, what have you done? It stinks in here. His voice made Beaver kitten Nory tremble. Nory, change back now, Hawthorne yelled. Ploof. He'd scared Nory into returning to her proper girl shape. Big hair, small body, brown skin, purple shirt. There was a bit of armchair fabric stuck in her teeth. Yuck, she spit it out. This was a disaster. The office and the bathroom were smelly messes. Father's favorite armchair looked like it had exploded. His antique desk tilted dangerously on three legs. Some of his precious books now resembled coleslaw. He was going to be really, really angry. Sorry, Nory whispered. Hawthorne looked mad and scared. Just help me clean, he told his sister. We don't have long. Together, they fixed up the damage as well as they could. They filled garbage bag after garbage bag. They wiped surfaces with spray cleaner. When the bathroom looked like a bathroom again, Hawthorne called a carpenter to repair the desk and armchair. He made Nory vacuum up the wood dust. He found the website for the Cup and Chaucer bookshop and ordered new copies of all the books Nory had ruined. When all this was done, Nory cleared her throat and asked, Hawthorne, are you still mad at me? He shook his head. You have to keep your human mind in control, Nory. That's all there is to it. I know. And when you turn into an animal, turn into a normal animal, he snapped. Stop mixing your parts up. You're getting really wonky and nobody likes it.
I was practicing kitten like you told me to, Nory explained. And then the beaver part just happened and everything went upside down.
That's what you were?
asked Hawthorne. A kitten beaver?
Beaver kitten, actually, said Nory. She thought for a moment, then grinned.
A bitten!
Whatever it was gross, Hawthorne said.
Nori's grin disappeared.
Plus, you lost control like you always do, Hawthorne continued. We'll have to blame Dahlia's rabbits, I guess.
Dahlia, the middle Horace child, was 13. She was a fuzzy and had a lot of pets, including 2 bats, 3 toads, a ferret, a toucan, a pair of mice, and 12 rabbits. They weren't well-behaved. The ferret pooped on the carpet. So did the toads. And the bats were always going in people's hair. It wasn't a stretch to blame Nori's mess on the bunnies. Still, Nory felt guilty. The rabbits shouldn't get in trouble for her mistake. Neither should Dahlia. She twisted her hands. Shouldn't we tell Father what really happened?
No, Hawthorne said. We don't want him angry at you. Not the day before the big test.
Nory bowed her head. Maybe Hawthorne was right. Some lies were safer than the truth. Up until summer vacation, Nory had gone to ordinary school like everyone else her age. Nori's ordinary school was called Woody Dale. It was kindergarten through 4th grade, just like all other ordinary schools. Nory had studied reading and writing, math and science, gym, art, and music. The one thing she hadn't studied was magic, since a person's powers didn't bubble up until around the time she or he turned 10. Once you were 10 and ready for 5th grade, you enrolled in a different school. You still had to read and do math and play basketball, but you also practiced magic. The kind of magic you practiced depended on your talent. Some kids were flares. They had fire talents, like Hawthorne. Some were fuzzies. They had animal talents, like Dahlia. Others were flickers or flyers or fluxers. Nory was a fluxer, although she wasn't a regular fluxer. Her magic was unusually big. Unlike most fluxers, she could turn into lots of animals. But Nory hid her magic from Father because it always went wonky. For example, she'd be a perfectly nice skunk and suddenly swell up to the size of an elephant. And then grow a trunk. Or she'd be a perfectly nice puppy and then grow squid legs. Nory knew that Father would disapprove of a puppy with squid legs. He would disapprove a lot. Another problem was that girl Nory almost always lost control of her human self during her transformations and ended up making a huge mess. Skunkophant Nory had become obsessed with finding peanuts and had stunk up the Horace kitchen. They'd had to scrub everything with bleach and convince Father that some real skunks had snuck through the kitchen window. Puppy Squid Nory had chewed all of Dahlia's shoes and then squirted Hawthorne with nasty squid ink. Hawthorne had claimed he'd been the victim of an exploding pen. Even Black Kitten had gone wrong 4 different ways. The scariest was when Nory had developed a touch of dragon and breathed fire at the sofa. Hawthorne had taken the blame for that one, telling Father he'd goofed up a flare seat warming project. Father had bought a new sofa and made Hawthorne pay for part of it. But Nory wondered if he'd really been fooled. Hawthorne got top marks in flair studies at Sage Academy. He never would have made a mistake like that. Father must have known that Nori's transformation power was out of control. He just didn't want to talk about it. He didn't talk about a lot of things. When Father got home from Sage Academy that evening, Hawthorne told him about the damage. Immediately, Father marched to his office to see it for himself. Hawthorne, Dahlia, and Nory followed.
Dahlia, Father said, frowning at the scratch marks on his desk. You have got to get those rabbits in line. Discipline is what they need. Discipline and a better lock on their pen. You'll take care of that, yes?
Yes, Father, Dahlia said.
She glared at Nory. Father hesitated.
Well, thank you, Hawthorne, for calling the carpenter and for ordering new copies of my books.
Hawthorne nodded. Father glanced at Nory. For a second, she thought he was going to say something to her. Maybe he would ask her what really happened. Maybe he'd offer his help. Instead, he clenched and unclenched his fingers 3 times. The entire messed-up office disappeared around them. Most flickers could make things invisible, but only extremely powerful flickers could make an entire room disappear while people were still standing in it. All the edges were neat and even, too.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.